Welcome to Space News from the Electric Universe, brought to you by the Thunderbolts Project at thunderbolts.info. For the last 4 years on this series, Space News from the Electric Universe, we have offered a theoretical basis for a new understanding of many surprising phenomena on planets and other bodies in the solar system. The electrical connectedness between the sun and planets, moons, comets, and asteroids is critical to understanding countless mysteries confronting space scientists. One such phenomenon is major dust-raising events seen on rocky bodies, from global dust storms that sometimes encompass the planet Mars, to the mysterious plumes recently imaged jetting hundreds of kilometers above the Martian surface, to weird configurations of dust patterns, including sand dunes, seen on the surface of the comet 67P, and even electrostatic dust fountains on the moon, witnessed by Apollo astronauts in the 1960s. These phenomena are to be expected in an electric universe, where all bodies within the sun's electrical influence are charged bodies. Electric fields produce ionic winds on planets, moons, and even comets, which can transport dust material more efficiently than mechanical wind. A new paper from NASA-funded scientists affirms this tenet of the electric universe theory. The research, published in the Geophysical Research Letters, involved experiments that exposed dust particles to UV radiation and to plasma. On July 1, 2016, the website phys.org published the article, "Static Electricity May Transport Dust Across Airless Planetary Bodies." It states that the experiments, quote, bring closure to a long-standing issue of electrostatic dust transport, explaining a variety of unusual phenomena on the surfaces of airless planetary bodies, including observations from the Apollo era to the recent Rosetta comet mission. The article continues, "The movement of electrons in the tiny spaces between dust particles can generate surprisingly large charges and forces, which can lift and move dust particles off the ground. In addition to single particles, clusters of dust were lofted, which showed that electrostatic processes may be responsible for the Rosetta detection of fluffy dust particles released from the surface of comet 67P. These laboratory observations reveal that dusty surfaces can become smooth due to dust mobilization and could help explain the formation of the, quote, dust ponds like those seen on asteroid Eros and comet 67P, and the unexpectedly smooth surface on Saturn's icy satellite Atlas. The principal investigator of the research team says of the findings, electrostatic dust processes have been hypothesized to explain these space observations. However, no theories until now were able to support these explanations. For the electric universe community, it is encouraging to see these discussions entering mainstream scientific literature. However, in light of the aforementioned statement, we note that in May of 1997, Wal Thornhill explained the electrical dust production of comets. And since its inception well over a decade ago, the Thunderbolts Project has argued, from sound theoretical considerations, that electrostatic dust transportation occurs on airless bodies in space, as well as bodies with extremely tenuous atmospheres, like the planet Mars. Since 2003, Picture of the Day articles on thunderbolts.info have offered a new theoretical interpretation for dust-raising events and conventionally mysterious dust forms on planets, moons, comets, and asteroids. More recently, prior to the Rosetta mission to the comet 67P, the Thunderbolts Project predicted the discovery of electric fields at the comet nucleus, and that electrical activity would reconfigure dust forms on the comet's surface. The completely unexpected discovery of sand dunes on 67P led mission scientists to propose an extreme process similar to saltation in Earth geology, which would require both an atmosphere and turbulent winds acting on the comet nucleus. But from the dune's discovery, the position of the Thunderbolts Project has been that electric fields produce ionic winds, which shape the dune-like features, as demonstrated in this experiment by Billy Overton. We also note that for decades, institutional science has acknowledged certain electrostatic potentials in space, but mostly for man-made objects. Following this surprising discovery, some scientists considered similar effects on comet and asteroid surfaces. In the 1981 paper on the electrostatic charging of the cometary nucleus, the author suggests that, quote, Dust particles can be electrostatically levitated and also be totally blown off of the cometary surface. Electrostatic levitation of dust has also been proposed for asteroids, again theoretically due to direct surface exposure to solar radiation and the solar wind. However, we must outline the fundamental differences between the Electric Universe predictions for electrically charged comets and asteroids, and electrostatic dust transportation on planets and moons, versus the occasional suggestions that have appeared in the scientific literature. The Electric Universe recognizes Hannes Alfvén's electric circuit of the Sun, which requires a vast, weak electric field centered on the Sun. Such an electric field is required to explain the still mysterious solar wind acceleration and coronal heating. All bodies within the Sun's field are electrically charged. In recent years, continued surprising discoveries have led more and more professional scientists to theoretical explanations that bear a closer resemblance to those of the Electric Universe. A 2008 NASA report described the fairly recent discovery that Earth's magnetotail creates powerful electric fields near the lunar surface, occasionally causing dramatic dust storms. As noted by NASA scientist Tim Stubbs, Earth's magnetotail extends well beyond the orbit of the Moon, and once a month, the Moon orbits through it. This could have consequences ranging from lunar dust storms to electrostatic discharges. More recently, scientists have discovered an astonishing clue to the so-called baffling plumes seen jetting hundreds of kilometers above the surface of Mars. Scientists using data from the Mars Express spacecraft have found something completely unexpected to mainstream planetary scientists. A coronal mass ejection appeared to hit Mars immediately before the plume was first spotted. As one investigating scientist stated, "It's very surprising that was affecting Mars right before the plume was first observed." A new scientist report on these findings states, "One possibility is that plasma could be interacting with ice grains or dust lower down in the atmosphere and electrically charging them, boosting them higher, but it's not clear how the effect would be big." But in the Electric Universe theory, the Martian ionosphere is always electrically charged, with electrical effects reaching directly to the ground. Like a capacitor, the planet accumulates electrical charge, and dramatic dust-raising events can occur when the atmosphere breaks down and electrical discharge activity is initiated. As we will see in forthcoming episodes, including a report on astonishingly powerful electric fields recently measured at the planet Venus, it seems that each new discovery is leading science to a slow yet inevitable recognition of our electric universe. For continuous updates on space news from the Electric Universe, stay tuned to thunderbolts.info.